สวัสดีค่ะ So now we are in chapter 2 of General Chemistry 2. This one is about acids and base. This is the example of common acid and base. This is the vinegar. We have different type of vinegar. This is lime, lemon. These are example of acid which everyone knows about the property and use them. Well, I like the taste of lime very much. And these are the example of some of the base or base producing solution. The acid and base were first recognized very simple by the test. The acid are sour, where base are a little bit bitter. If we look at common acids in terms of the chemical formula, you probably have seen this formula CH3COOH already. Everyone should know this is the acetic acid. And this is the substance that we found in vinegar. Other acids that are shown here, acetyl salicylic acid that we found in aspirin, ascorbic acid, which is vitamin C, carbonic acid in soft drinks, citric acid in the citrus fruits like lemon, lime, oranges, hydrochloric acid in the stomach, in our body, which is very essential for the digestion of the food. The nitric acid that used in making fertilizer, or it can make explosive. And sulfuric acid that is in the car batteries. So we see already here that there are so many acid which is used in industry, and it is very important in our body as well. It's very important in biological processes as well. And if you look at the chemical formula, you can see one thing in common here, that most acid has the hydrogen involved. And this is gonna be the characteristic of the acid that we're gonna learn after. Let's see some common base. In the picture, we see some antacid, which is aluminum hydroxide. We can have some other base like ammonium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, sodium bicarbonate, or another name, sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is the baking soda. The sodium carbonate, sodium hydroxide, and the sodium hypochlorite that used in many bleach to clean stuff. So for base, one thing in common that you can see from this slide is that the structure consists of hydroxide. Not every one of the base has hydroxide, however, but it still has the property of the base. So we're gonna learn about the definition of acid and base. After this, why do we take this substance into the group of base and the one before into the group of acid? So from this slide, you can see that I have written here acid-base definitions in plural. So it already means that we have more than one definition for acid or base. And it is listed here for you that we have three definitions. The first one is the Arrhenius definition. The second one is the Bronsted-Lowry definition. The third one is the Lewis definition. Obviously, they are different in terms of the meaning of the acid and base substance. Let's have a look at the first one, the Arrhenius definition. Arrhenius is the very first person who came up with this idea to identify the substance, separate them into acid and base. He looked at substance that dissolve into water. The very important aspect of this definition is that it is limit to aqueous solution or has water as solvent only. Arrhenius gave the definition for acid as a substance that dissolve in water and increase the concentration of hydronium ion. For base, he suggested that it is a substance that dissolve in water and increase concentration of hydroxide ion. So this definition is very limited, as you may already see that first of all, you have to look at substance in water. Without water, you will not be able to identify acid or base. Another thing that you may see here that for a substance to be base, it's gonna have to produce hydroxide ion. If not, you cannot identify it as a base. So it already has limit to this definition. For some substance that has already been known as base, like ammonia, which has the formula NH3, doesn't have OH at all, cannot be identified as base by Arrhenius. So a broader definition is needed. Before going to that, let's have a look at the definition of acid and base. By looking at the equation, chemical equation that involve, it said here acid dissolve in water, increase hydronium ion. So this is the example of acid dissolve in water. So it is in water. The product, one of them, has to be hydronium ion plus some other anion, that is the remaining of this acid. Some chemists or some textbook or in general, we can leave that water out from equation. So the acid can be something that separate into proton or H positive, we call this proton, and it's an ion. So for Arrhenius' definition, if you see something that produce hydronium ion or proton, you can think of it as acid. And in the textbook, the hydronium ion and proton sometimes are used interchangeable to represent acid solution. For the base, such as sodium hydroxide, in water, it will produce hydroxide ion. So sodium hydroxide is a base by definition of Arrhenius. As I said earlier, it is very limited. So we need a broader definition to be able to identify, for example, ammonia as a base. So the second definition that we will look at is the Bronsted-Lowry definition. This is the work of two scientists, Mr. Lowry and Mr. Bronsted. They both came up with the same idea to identify acid and base as acid is a species or substance that donate proton in a proton transfer reaction. And of course, base is a species or substance that accepting the proton in the proton transfer. So in this definition, there is no specific saying about the solution must be in aqueous solution. The only main idea is about the proton transfer. So So one substance must be able to donate proton or hydrogen. Another substance must be able to accept proton. When we talk about transfer reaction, we're gonna have to look at two species at the same time. One give, one take. Alright? So if we look at the transfer reaction, donate and accept proton. So we have to look at least two species here. The one that is shown here, HCl. In the reaction, it transfer this hydrogen or proton to a substance that is water, H2O here. The product from this transfer of proton give this hydronium ion and the chloride ion. So by definition of Bronsted and Lowry, HCl donate proton to water. Donate proton is an acid. Water, H2O, accept proton. H2O accept proton. So it is referred to as a base in this reaction. Have a look at another example. So if we have the same HCl in reaction with ammonia NH3, the product is ammonium ion NH4 positive and chloride ion. Looking at this reaction, HCl must donate its proton to ammonia. So HCl donate proton, it is an acid. Where ammonia accept proton, so it, by this definition, it is a base. So there can be no water involved in acid-base reaction according to Bronsted and Lowry. The last one is the Lewis definition. Here, we are talking about the transfer of electron. Transfer of electron. Lewis gives definition of acid as electron pair acceptor. Electron pair acceptor. And base is an electron pair donor. Donor is the one that gives away the electron pair. Acceptor is the one that take electron pair. So this is a very useful definition where we talk about the bonding in coordination compound, such as boron trifluoride here react with ammonia. The product is this substance. The bonding occur between boron and nitrogen atom here. The explanation by acid base in Lewis F definition is this. Base, ammonia, has this lone pair electron to transfer to the boron. Nitrogen has lone pair electron to transfer to boron to make bonding. So ammonia is electron pair donor. Boron trifluoride is electron pair acceptor. According to the definition, boron trifluoride would be acid and ammonia would be base. Now that we learn all three definitions of acid and base, Arrhenius, Bronsted, and Lewis, all the definitions must be agreeable in terms of identifying substance into acid or base. If Arrhenius define HCl into acid because in water This one will increase concentration of hydronium ion. Bronsted Lowry also identify HCl as acid because it will donate proton in a reaction, as well as ammonia, which cannot be identified as bad by Arrhenius because it doesn't have hydroxide. However, it is identified by Bronsted-Lowry definition that is a base because it is the proton acceptor in reaction. In Lewis definition, ammonia is also a base because it is an electron pair donor. So both hydrochloric acid and ammonia are identified correctly by any definitions. Water is a special substance which can be identified as acid or base. This is the special property of water that it is called an amphiprotic species. Amphiprotic species is a species that can gain or lose a proton. Gain or lose a proton. It can donate proton or it can accept proton in acid-base reaction. So water, when it gives proton, it will be acid like this one. Reaction between water and ammonia. Water and ammonia. Water would donate proton to ammonia and become ammonium ion. Water itself will be hydroxide. So water donates proton. It is an acid. In a reaction where water reacts with hydrochloric, water reacts with hydrochloric. This time, water accepts proton from hydrochloric and become hydronium ion. So in this reaction, water acts as a base, a substance that can act either as acid or base is called amphoteric. So water can gain or lose a proton. It is amphiprotic. It can act as acid or base in reaction, it is called amphoteric. So in summary of this video, we talk about some common acid and base which we see in everyday life. We identify acid or base according to its reaction. We learn about three definitions of acid and base: Arrhenius definition, Bronsted-Lowry definition, and Lewis definition. Acid in Arrhenius definition is a substance that increases hydronium ion in water. Base is a substance that increases hydroxide ion in water. In Bronsted-Lowry concept, acid is the one that donates proton. Base is the one that accepts proton. In Lewis definition, acid is the one that accepts electron pair. Base is the one that donates electron pair. So hopefully, you can identify substance into acid or base by any of these definitions. I see you next time, นะคะ สวัสดีค่ะ